Morning. Welcome back to Mindful Monday. I want to start today with a little bit of a review because I realize that there might be some of you who are joining us who haven't tuned in to the previous weeks. And so there's a couple important points about mindfulness that I'll quickly repeat before we go into what we're going to talk about today. So the three words that capture what mindfulness really means are, same with me, friends, be, here, now. Mindfulness really only means those three words. Being present in the moment that we're currently living is mindfulness. Paying attention to what's happening right now is being mindful. And the reasons that we think about mindfulness and we practice it are that it has some significant benefits for us. It gives us three important things. It makes us happier, it makes us healthier, and it improves all of our relationships, which is pretty incredible. So it's worth practicing. It's an important part of becoming a whole and happy person. So today we're going to think back to one of our previous talks where we talked about feelings, and we talked about the importance of being able to stop and feel feelings when they're happening and be able to name them. And naming them is a really important part of handling feelings. So today I want to expand on that a little bit. I hope you've been practicing naming your feelings, even the uncomfortable ones, especially if you have people around you and you let them know with your words how you're feeling. That can be a really powerful tool to help you and others that you're with pass through difficult moments. So continue to practice naming your feelings. And today I want to invite you into a thought. Some other people have shared with me, and that is we can think of our feelings like weather. And I thought, that's interesting. So a happy feeling might be like sunny weather with birds chirping in the sky and little white fluffy clouds. And a mad feeling might be a thunderstorm or really, really hard whipping winds. And, you know, there might be sad feelings that feel like just kind of gloomy, gray, drizzly weather. You know, we can kind of attach a feeling to different kinds of weather. But I want to invite an idea for you, and that is that weather, like our feelings, are constantly changing. Weather doesn't stay the same. It will always change. And so do our feelings. And so that's good news, right? I mean, sometimes I guess we would want our happy feelings to hang on for a really long time, right? But if we never had the sad feelings, we wouldn't know how great the happy feelings are. So the contrast is kind of nice. But here's what happens to people, me included, other adults included. When we're having a big feeling, especially maybe a frustration or an anger, or a sadness, it feels like it's all consuming. It feels like it is us. It's the feeling of the feeling being us. But what I'd ask you or invite you to think about is that you are not the feeling. You are experiencing the feeling as it passes through in a very similar way that the sky experiences the weather. The sky isn't the weather. The sky is experiencing the weather is passing through the sky. Yeah, but the sky remains the same. The weather passes through. So when you're feeling a happy feeling, I hope that you appreciate it and enjoy it for what it is, knowing that it will also pass. And then when you're feeling the sad and the frustration and the angry feelings, I hope you can also know and remember that those feelings are not you. They are weather passing through. You are the sky. Thanks for joining me today. I leave you with a kind heart, kind words, and kind thoughts.